We're in a subway listening to something. We're in a bar trying to listen to something, you know, and what we do to accommodate for the noise, we turn things up and at the same time make us susceptible to noise-induced hearing loss. So I was doing a Zoom meeting on the train. And as I was walking out on the streets from Grand Central to come to my Midtown office to see patients this morning, I had my earbuds in, I'm listening to the meeting, and suddenly a truck came by. And what I really wanted to do, I couldn't hear a damn thing now, because even though my volume was set at a level where I could have heard things before, and now with the truck in the background, I could not. And so the assumption on my part is that I need to turn my volume up. And that's the trap that we all fall into. The World Health Organization thinks that there are 1.1 billion young individuals, not old fogies like me anymore, you know, but young individuals who are at risk for hearing loss from noise exposure. Finding out about something after it has already had an impact on you is a little too late. And it isn't always possible to then intervene to make something better. And this is why I think this campaign is, in my mind, is so meaningful, because really education, information, and eliminating ignorance when it comes to hearing health is very worthwhile. Keep listening safely. What are the consequences of everyday activity, like using earbuds to listen to music? How long to listen to it? How loud can you make it safely? Let's put the answers out there. Let's not wait for people to ask us. Let's let people know. This campaign to make people aware of noise-induced hearing loss, we call it Keep Listening, because our goal isn't to have people stop listening. That's just the wrong message. Abstinence of hearing is not what we're going for here.